It's a party! A pee-pee. So Harry! Get ready for the paper! I nursed you back to health too, Tiny. Yeah, I was nursed. That took me a nurse. Had to be nursed. Mm. Better burgers.
Well, I figured out why the cats were puking all the time.
Ah, bah! Pee pee! Bah! Put up! We're playing! Walk up here like a chair! And pee pee! Pee pee! Jimmy? Oh, put up! Fuck him, you put you. I did poop. Catch a pussy. That's it. You catch a carpet.
He's playing around on the floor. I helped him get all excited. He was being obnoxious last night, chasing the boob around, chasing the junior. Well, he didn't chase the junior, he just scared him off a little. He's like the bully of the cats. He bullies everyone around.
Hey, yeah, pee pee.
So I've been giving him more attention. We're having our 1 hour of prayer time here. I just woke up from the sleepy eye. That's usually the way I do it.
Burger nose! She's feeling a burger nose.
You can always tell when Tiny's feeling better because she starts wanting to play too. Start moving under the covers with her fingers. And she starts going at it.
Yeah, I'm feeling better, bird. Hey, you feeling better, bird? Yeah, I'm feeling better, bird.
Well, I can tell I got overexcited because my tailbone's starting to hurt. Everything was doing fine until I started getting all excited.
Ah, Tiny! Really? Really?
I have to move my pressure regulator when I talk or when I sing or when I get excited. I have to move the pressure regulator up the diaphragm, up this way. Do it from up here in the chest region instead of down the belly. So whenever I expand the belly, it puts pressure on the tailbone area. So I have to train myself to start doing that.
Pee-pee! Ah, pee-pee! Are you on your little carpet? Ah, I'm on the carpet! I'm on the carpet! Ah! Ah! Ah, oh, Tiny! You're feeling better, aren't you, Better Burgers? Yeah, I feel better.
Well, I found a program last night, a computer program. For free, that will turn sound into musical sheet music, live sound, voice, guitar, you name it, anything that can be sung into a microphone. So I did my first test last night, and everything works. Need some fine tuning though. Let me read this. It's freeware for life, but they just give you some of the features of the paid version. But, called MIDI Illustrator. I've just been going to town on bookmarks. So, cleared it. Now you can, we can take the stuff and we can convert MP3s to MIDI files with this program. The limited version only has 30 seconds of two 30-second pieces. So here's an example of the we'll do this by Johann.
Johann Sebastian Bach.
No, Johann Sebastian Bach. Don't forget to put that on the end of it. Clear the throat. Johann Sebastian Bach. Here's an MP3. Johann Sebastian Bach. So that was the MP3. Now let's listen to see how the program converted that to a MIDI file. Now remember, a MIDI file is a file that we can drag and drop into the MuseScore program over Macintosh. Now this MIDI Illustrator runs on PC, so I just had my eyes opened last night that I do have Windows XP on my Macintosh, so I was able to run the IntelliScore program, and so that opened my eyes to all kinds of other programs that I was reading up on. They were all Macintosh programs, so I can start doing Macintosh music programs now. There's a lot more free Macintosh music programs or PC programs than there are Macintosh programs. Okay, so let's listen to how it converted. This is the MIDI file. Okay, now with this program, this is the thing that my expectations are that I'll be able to play my guitar and it will make my guitar into a MIDI file. I can take that guitar MIDI file, plug it into MuseScore, and it will lay out the notes in music, and I can put the numbers above each note, and I can analyze my own playing. If it will do this. So it says it'll do 16th notes and even faster notes than that, so we'll see. That was an example of multi-instruments. That has example for single instruments, like here's the 8th Sonata in C minor, 2nd movement, Pathetique, by Ludwig Beethoven. Call Ludwig. I think these dudes are taking notes that are outside the scale on purpose and just using it one time as leading tones into the next phrase. All right, here's the MIDI file of the single instrument. As you can hear, it's a little bit off on its timing, but that was pretty good. It's pretty good though. It's not bad. And convert to WAV files too. They have an MP3 to WAV converter. Open the command prompt, change the folder where you stored our MP3 to WAV utility, then type MP3 to WAV at the prompt for user's instructions. This is the same utility used by IntelliScore to read MP3 files. Please understand that since this is freeware, we are offering it as an unable to provide technical assistance. If you want to convert MP3s to WAV files, to MIDI, download the big package. Anvil Studio, that's where I have the full version of IntelliScore, including Anvil Studio, the award-winning MIDI sequencer and notation software from Willow Software. Download the latest. Then we have Loop Bell, or Loopy. Loopy 1, the virtual MIDI device is useful for routing mid out back and is mid input, like a virtual patch cable, free from non-commercial use. Product information. Says here, do you want to use your analog instrument as a MIDI controller, but don't want to pay for an expensive MIDI pickup? If you've been struck with a great moment of inspiration and recorded a great new idea for a song or hot new lick, but can't remember what notes you played? Are you a music teacher who needs an easier way to write down a practice sequence for your students? Do you have a recording of a drum solo you want to see what you played? Are you a music copyist who is looking for a quicker alternative to playing an audio recording of a song over and over to pick out the notes and write them down? Skiddle-doo, skiddle-doo, skiddle-doo. Help you figure out for pre-recorded music. Let's say we have a CD of an artist. You can throw that into here and it will make music out of it. Cheap music. It'll do it. Won't do it totally perfect, We have to go in and edit the pitches and find some of the pitches that are out of tune and off time, though. So that's the thing about it. It's not fully automatic. It's they're still working on the DNA technology to perfect that. So this is probably an older version. But they probably have newer stuff out these days. Build a score. IntelliScore suggests complementing chord names from a set of 144 different chord bases. Create lead sheets, helps isolate the lead instrument or singing part from stereophonic wave or other files. Tune your instrument. Remove vocals, help remove vocals from stereophonic wave or other files for karaoke singing. Help remove vocals. Ringtone, save space, share your ideas with others via internet, MIDI, file, improv, download, time, and save. They have the polyphonic version and the ensemble version. Polyphonic means one, ensemble means many. It has chord detection. It has free email support. Even with the limited version, still you can get free email support. With the full version, you get phone support. View notation and tab and edit MIDI. Recorder, automatic tuning. It only has a score builder in the. And we have sure shots here. There's the screenshots. Looky here. 1 gigahertz or faster processor works on Macintosh in conjunction with Windows running under boot camp. So they do have a Macintosh version for the full version, but the limited version is just PC. it looks like I need to download Loopy One, as it helps to convert microphone stuff into the Anvil Studio. MIDI cannot store as much information as audio. MIDI data can indicate which notes to play, but not the sound of the note. It'll do drums by itself, but not with other instruments. IntelliScore can convert audio files to MIDI, but not the other way around. To convert MIDI back to WAV, we recommend MIDI Converter Studio. Also see facts on accuracy. IntelliScore employs several different conversion algorithms based on our own research in psychoacoustic physics and are very complex. For example, IntelliScore uses data obtained by analyzing thousands of recordings of musical instruments to help convert polyphonic music. IntelliScore's specialized monophonic algorithm is remarkably accurate on audio files as well as live performance that contains only one note at a time, and even detects slight variations in pitch, volume, and brightness. Nevertheless, some instruments and forms of music convert better than others. Some audio files may simply refuse to be converted. Conversion is generally best with audio files that are not too complex and contain only a few instruments and minimal drums or percussion. Although IntelliScore's ensemble can convert music with pitched instruments and percussion mixed together, best results are obtained when they are separate. To find out if IntelliScore will work for you, we recommend you download our free demo. Don't expect IntelliScore to convert a CD to finished music notation, but IntelliScore can get you well on your way, although after using IntelliScore you may need to clean up the music notation. And I spoke on that earlier. Users say this saves them an average 35% over having to figure out and enter the notes into a sequencer without IntelliScore's help. Can use the time you save to pursue more creative endeavors. You don't need a supercomputer to run it. The faster the CPU, the faster the conversion time. You don't have to be a rocket scientist to use it. Provides you a wizard, a screen wizard.
Hey, man.
quit whizzing on the screen. Who keeps whizzing on the screen over here?
It has been said that automated music conversion is the music equivalent of speech recognition. For this analogy to be true, then polyphonic music conversion is like listening to several conversations going on at once and figuring out all the words spoken by everyone. Perhaps it is due to this extra complexity that the technology of automated music conversion has lagged behind speech recognition. This is all based on research in psychoacoustic physics. It's now in its seventh generation. All right, so I can create the MIDI file in this program, take the MIDI file and throw it into MusicScore, and MusicScore is free, and it'll turn it all into music for me. Because in order for IntelliScore to do that for me, I'd have to buy the ensemble package, or the full version, the polyphonic. Polyphonic meaning just one instrument. The full version of IntelliScore includes the award-winning Anvil Studio program, but you can use any program that imports standard music MIDI files. So that's what it, yeah. So there, we just answered the question there in writing. Printing from the included Anvil Studio requires purchase of the optional print sheet accessory. Oh. So there is a program here to be able to print from Anvil. Print sheet accessory. The purchase, or it requires the purchase of the print sheet accessory. That's what they're selling. If you want to use your analog instrument as a real-time MIDI controller, be sure you have a MIDI interface to connect your computer to your synthesizer or sound generation module. If you want to use your analog instrument to record directly into your sequencer, you will need to use IntelliScore in conjunction with Loop B1 that can be downloaded without charge for non-commercial use. I might as well download that right now. That it would be. And I downloaded so many programs last night, it's hard to keep track of them all. I found Chinese music yesterday. It's all written in numbers. It's called Giant Poo. Or the Zipper Method. Zephyr. The Zephyr. The Zephyr. The Zipper Method with Giant Poo. It's from the Orient, man. The Chinese have been doing music by numbers for hundreds of years. That's the East for you, man. Oh, hold on a second here. Doesn't Telescore run on Macintosh? We do not currently offer a native Mac version of IntelliScore. However, IntelliScore runs perfectly on a Mac that is running Windows XP in conjunction with Parallels, Bootcamp, VirtualBox, Fusion. That answered that question. Then we have video tutorials. MP3 to notation music transcription software on Daily Motion. Okay, here's a video of live guitar to MIDI. This is an acoustic guitar. Let's check this out. He's playing two guitar parts here on the video. He has a... converts that to music. Looks like from reading some of the comments that he's already played, converted his music to MIDI, and he's just playing along with the MIDI with the guitar now. So that's why we hear two different instruments playing. That's very hopeful, because if it's that clear after he doctored it up, then
oh, that booger nose needs wipes. There you are.
Then the sheet music, the printed sheet notation, sheet music should come out real nice then.
Alright, so let's listen to the end of the video. make a playlist for that video. Guitar. It's a MIDI. It's a sheet music. This one's using Daily Motion. This is a 10-minute video.
This video is one of a series of lessons on how to use IntelliScore to help you transcribe music. You can download IntelliScore Ensemble from www.intelliscore.net. Today I'm going to show you how to convert audio recordings to multi-track MIDI files and work with results in Piano Roll View. You may have two questions at this point. What is a MIDI file, and why would I want to convert audio to MIDI? First, let's define audio files. When we speak of audio files, we are referring to digital recordings of music. The recordings may be stored on standard CDs or in various types of computer files, such as MP3 and WAV files. Now, unlike audio files, a MIDI file doesn't actually contain any sounds. Instead, it contains a list of musical notes in a song. Why would you want this? Say there's a song you want to play, but you don't have sheet music for it. What are your options? Well, you could listen to the song over and over again to pick out the notes and transcribe it entirely by hand. But that takes a lot of time, and it's really not that much fun, is it? The other option is to use IntelliScore to convert your song to a MIDI file. Then you can import the MIDI file into notation software to see the notes. IntelliScore helps convert your audio recordings to MIDI files to assist you in transcribing music, potentially saving you hours of time. Okay, let's see how IntelliScore works. What you see now is the main IntelliScore screen that appears when you open the application. To start a new conversion project, click on the icon in the top left corner. This opens a new project wizard, which will ask us some questions about the music and what we want to do with it. The first step is to tell IntelliScore where the music is. For example, it can be on a file in your computer. It could be on a standard audio CD. You can record directly into IntelliScore, etc. For this demonstration, the music is on an MP3 file, so let's select the first option. Click Next.
So, I'll be able to go into GarageBand and I can isolate all my guitar parts and all my vocal parts, turn them into MP3 files, and then run them through this converter, and it will turn all those solos and the sheet music.
File selector window opens. There's the file right there. Select it and click open. So that you know what the music sounds like, I'm going to click the play button to play it. While it plays, try to pick out what instruments you hear. You'll use that information later. Sounds like the music contains a piano, trumpet, trombones, and bass. Since we know what instruments the music contains, let's select the first option. I know what instruments comprise the original audio. Click Next. Now, since the music has more than one type of instrument in it, let's select the multiple option. By selecting multiple, we're ensuring that we will end up with a multi-track MIDI file. Click Next. Now this is where we tell IntelliScore what instruments are in the music. A set of instruments is called an ensemble. If we click the folder button, you'll see there are plenty of predefined ensembles. For example, country and jazz trio. We could select one of these as a starting point, but for this demonstration, we're going to create our own ensemble from scratch. Click the globe button to open the ensemble editor. As you see, the default ensemble contains piano and organ. We're going to leave the piano alone, since there is in fact a piano in our music. However, for organ, we're going to switch it to one of the other instruments that are in our music, say trumpet, which is down here at number 56. We are asked if we want IntelliScore to adjust some parameters to match the instrument. Let's say yes. Now let's add the trombone to the list. First, activate the channel, and then select trombone, which is down at number 57. Okay, now I heard two trombones playing different notes in the music, so I'm going to make a small adjustment to the polyphony. And now for the bass, let's go ahead and select that one, number 32, acoustic bass. Okay, we're done selecting the instruments. When IntelliScore is done, we will have a four-track MIDI file with one track each for piano, trumpet, trombone, and bass. Click OK. Now we're back at the wizard. Click Next. Here we need to make a choice based on how we're going to use the MIDI file. IntelliScore can either make a MIDI file optimized for listening or optimized for notation. For this demonstration, we don't need notation, so let's select the easy timing option. Click Next. Of course, we need a name for our MIDI file that is about to be created. Let's just accept the name that IntelliScore suggests for us. Click Next. Now we're done with the wizard. Click Finish, and off it goes. Okay, the MIDI file is ready. As you can see, IntelliScore has not only created a MIDI file from the MP3 file, but it has also estimated the key of the music, which is C-sharp minor, the tuning, the tempo, and the meter. Now we can decide what we're going to do with our MIDI file. First, let's just listen to it and compare it with the MP3 file. We're going to click on the Sync Player option. First, let's listen to the original audio. Now let's listen to the MIDI that IntelliScore created from the audio. Okay, that's a pretty good starting point to help us with transcribing this music, but we will want to clean it up. For this, let's look at the notes that IntelliScore detected by opening the MIDI file in MIDI editing software. We have configured IntelliScore to use Anvil Studio as our MIDI editor software, since the basic version of Anvil Studio is included with IntelliScore. Now select the second option, Open MIDI File in MIDI Editor Notation Software. IntelliScore opens Anvil Studio and imports our MIDI file. Let's select View Mixer. As you can see, our MIDI file contains four tracks that match the ensemble we defined earlier. The first track is the piano part, followed by the trumpet, the trombone, and the bass part. Suppose we're only interested in the trumpet part. We can adjust the volume sliders to zero for all the tracks except the trumpet part. Now, let's click View, Piano Roll Editor. The piano roll view looks like a grid. The notes are on a vertical axis, while time is on a horizontal axis. Let's now click the play button. You're going to see and hear the trumpet part. You may have noticed there are some extra high notes that were not in the original audio. For example, this high-pitched note right here. We can right-click on it and select Remove Note. Now it's gone. Here are several short notes that should be one sustained note. We can right-click on the first note and select Join This with the Next Note. Do that again to make it one sustained note. Now let's rewind to the beginning and listen to the trumpet part with our corrections. To edit the other instrument parts, we can go back to the mixer. For bass, we can raise the volume of the bass and reduce all the other instruments to zero. That way, we'll hear only the bass part. Then we can go back to the piano roll editor to modify the bass part. Once we are satisfied with the transcription, we can select File, Save Song to save all our edits. That concludes this lesson. For more information on IntelliScore and to view more lessons, please visit www.intelliscore.net.
All right, so there's our prayer time for an hour.